Hi, Art Seekers. We are here with Kelly Tolles in DC in your fabulous studio. I'm so excited to get to talk to you.
It's a pleasure to have you.
So how did you come from the world of graffiti to the world of street art?
I used to live in Australia. In Australia, all we had was like BBC One. So when I was living there, it was Alice Springs, actually. And it's the dead center of the desert. Really not a lot to do. So what I watched was like Astro Boy and Voltron and Young Ones and Goody. So it was like anime and dark British humor. So basically, I carried that with me when we moved back to the US and stuff like that, and then kind of had a crappy home life. So that transitioned to doing graffiti and being a pissed off kid. And then I wasn't really good at graffiti, so it kind of translated to just me drawing things back from like the anime kind of deal.
And how do you see the differences aesthetically between your early graffiti work and then the work that you're doing now?
I think it's always evolving. It's like back in the day, like you think you're doing something like intellectual, and I felt it's more primitive. And then now it's gotten to the point where it's, I don't know, it just keeps changing, because I'll always love making a mess. Like I'm very chaotic when it comes to working, and it's very fast and sometimes, I guess, primitive as well. But when it comes into appreciating things and wanting to express that, like the female figure and things of that nature, or whatever I'm interested at that certain point in time, is where I see it constantly going. But it's always comes back into this real translation of chaos and then like refinement. And I don't think any one artist knows their path, which is beautiful. But I think that once you realize that you don't have to attain a certain thing, if you just keep exploring and doing what you're doing, you'll just keep figuring out things.
Something else I really appreciate about how you operate in a public space is that there's such an alignment with your activism, that you use art as a platform to share your message. How did you get involved in that?
I think it comes from like being that extroverted sensibility of someone just being like you don't become an artist because you like people telling you what the fuck to do. You really don't. Like it's just really that standpoint of, and you don't start doing graffiti or anything like that because you love people telling you what to do. But it's that other like thing of where if you don't use your voice, then you've got to use something else. And that it is my outlet. It is my outlet 100%. Like, because I love being able to be cheeky or like whimsical, or, you know, getting a point across through a different means than having it shoved right in your face or up your ass. Giving people art for free is an amazing gift. Like it's honest and it's brutal, because like the honesty that you're trying to portray, like, just I would love to show everyone this, and the brutality of it is that you have the people that hate it and this and that and the other, and they're not afraid to unleash on you just as much as you're honest. So it's a real eye-opener after doing it for a while. But also, like, if you can grow that thick skin and just like keep just believing in that message that you're doing, is really, really empowering.
How would you define the aesthetic of the public art scene or the street art scene? Because that's such a collision, right? We have public art, like all the traditional monuments, and then we have murals.
Right.
And so that's a really interesting juxtaposition too.
Yeah. So the real interesting challenge for DC, for being creative, street art, public art, whatever you want to call it, is that DC is still conservative by far in nature. Like, you want to say we're like kind of like 5 years behind, like, I don't know, the fashion game, and like 5 years this and 5 years that. But the thing is that in the next 5 years, we're going to be caught up to like everything. But there's still that conservative nature, because I've actually had people from like Barack Obama's White House team. I've done a commission or two for them. So, but the artwork had to be a certain thing. You can't have an artwork where someone goes into the house and just like it's like vaginas everywhere. Like I'm not deterring that. It's just it will not happen in DC unless you're like a gynecologist or something like that. It's just not going to happen. But it's also the challenge, because it's like that shock art value thing, is that you can't do that here for the most part. If you do it, you're oh, it's going to be even more scandalous. That's really not, because people like kind of push it even aside even more. The thing is that if you're even more creative in these confines, which is how we run Powwow DC, how we run the festival, is there's no sex, no violence, no politics. If you can work within that and make it PG friendly and whatever you do, it doesn't matter who you are. If you can conquer that and make it amazing, you're going to get 10 times more attention and 10 times more press. And it's not that should be the recipe. It's just the current climate of right now.
But you can also support a cause without being overtly provocative or inflammatory. And I think that some of your characters do mm-hmm. that, like the heart with the boxing gloves.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I did a heart for the boxing gloves for the Human Rights Campaign. I did a t-shirt for them. And that's exactly like the kind of thing that you can do. But like they wanted to jazz up the heart with, because I always put like tattoos and stuff on it. They're like, we want a unicorn and we want this and we want that. I'm like, I'm down with that. But it's like one of those things. It's like you can have fun with it. You can be smart and intelligent about it. And you can work within the confines. You don't have to be out of control or whatever. You're like, you can do that, but putting it in the public eye, sometimes for free, or if someone's paying you for a mural and this and that and the other, there's that counterbalance and weight of what you have to do. And like running a festival, we've done over 35 murals now, just in one section of DC. And doing all those murals, you have to put your community under like a conversation, talk with them, see what they want, because it's not just you. And you put it out there, and if you have the ability to have those conversations with those people, the amount of support that you'll get back is tenfold. I would not be here doing what I am as an artist unless I was supported by my community at all.